If you need me, call me. No matter where you are, no matter how far, just call my name. I'll be there to hurry. On that you can depend and never worry. You see, my love is alive. It's like a seed that only needs a thought of you to grow.
Diana.
So if you feel the need for company,
Diana.
Please, my darling.
Diana.
Who is that?
It's me, Diana, your director.
I know, but you didn't give me a chance. If you just give me a chance, I will do it. Okay, I'll do it now. Ladies and gentlemen, hi, and welcome to our show. For the next hour, you will be entertained by me and my marvelous guest stars. There'll be some singing and some dancing and a whole lot of fun. We hope you like it. Okay?
No, dear, that's not it. You're off your mark.
I'm off my mark?
Yes, dear. Will you just take a few steps to your left?
Well, isn't this where I'm supposed to be?
I doubt it.
But why?
Well, for one thing, you're standing in 3 feet of water.
No.
Diana Ross, with guest stars Danny Thomas, the Jackson 5, and special guest star Bill Cosby.
Your name so they'll know you, okay?
Okay. My name is Kennedy.
How old are you?
Six.
You're 6 years old? Nah.
Yes, I am.
Nah.
I'm not five anymore.
Oh, shoot.
If I was five, I wouldn't have been up in the state.
Oh, yeah. Okay. What's your name?
Charles Heyman.
Hey, do you have a favorite group?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Jackson 5.
Yeah? I want to tell you something to do for me. Would you do that for me, okay?
Ladies and gentlemen, the Jackson 5!
Your note. You print nicely.
I always did.
You couldn't possibly mean what you said.
I do. Since I'm leaving you, I thought you should be the first to know.
Then it's really over?
Come now. We've been on the train to nowhere, and it's time to get off. Now, my dear. It isn't as bad as all that. There'll be others.
Yes, but not like you. When will I find somebody with your charm, your wit, your lips?
You won't. But hang on in there.
Men, you're all alike, cruel, heartless, egocentric.
Flattery will get you nowhere.
Tell me, is there another woman? I'd like to know. Is there another woman? Tell me.
Well,
don't tell me.
Get a hold of yourself, woman.
Well, I'm trying to. Why are you leaving me? Why?
Well, for one thing, you've lost your je ne sais quoi.
What?
Your je ne sais quoi.
What's that?
I don't know, but you'll find it missing.
You know, Michael, I've scrubbed for you. I've washed for you. I've cooked for you. I worked my fingers to the bone.
That's another thing. I can't stand bony fingers.
Then there's nothing more to say?
No.
Then this is au revoir?
And also, goodbye.
Like me, I wanna be.
Wouldn't want to offend you, Mr. Crosby, but,
I told you it's not Crosby. My name is Cosby. C-R-C-O-S-B-Y. Cosby.
Okay, Mr. Crosby. I mean, sorry about that. Bill Cosby, I'm very happy to have you on my show, but, didn't they tell you that, this was going to be kind of formal?
Yeah.
I mean, why would you come dressed like that?
Like what?
You know.
Sure.
I gotta tell you, why would you do that?
You're talking about my dribbling slippers? Mm-mm. No, my dribbling slippers stay with me no matter what, formal or informal.
Oh.
They go where I go. They've been partners with my feet since my stickball days in Philadelphia. Did you ever play stickball when you were a kid in Detroit?
Well, I did get to play once, but that's only because the fellas needed a stick.
I see. But I remember one game when I was a kid. The score was tied for the championship of the world, 912-912.
Well, you must have been playing for days.
You better believe it. And as a matter of fact, they called the game on account of winner.
Yeah.
And that's when I met Alberta.
Alberta?
Alberta was my first true love. Alberta. My goodness gracious. Alberta was like a small leaf cast away into the sands of time. Yea, though I walk with her. She was so beautiful. And so...
I'm tired. Aren't you
tired of playing?
No.
No, man. Tired of playing? This is only the 43rd ending.
Yeah, well, I'm going to just get on over here and quit. That's all.
What you going to do?
I'm going to sit down here and do nothing.
How do you do nothing?
Well, first of all, you think of something to do, and then you don't do it.
You expect us to believe this the only reason you can hang around here?
Well, of course, man. Of course, you guys probably never thought about the fact that I just might be in love.
In love?
In love?
That's
who are you in love with?
Alberta.
Got to be kidding, baby.
I'm not kidding. I dig her.
You dig Alberta?
Yes, I do.
Or is it her daddy's candy store?
Does her father have a candy store?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, you know it, man.
I didn't know.
You know it.
Who
you think you're fooling?
I'm not jiving nobody. You know he got
know it. You didn't know it.
I had no idea that her father had a candy store.
And you ain't going to amount to nothing, buddy.
Yeah. I'm not.
That's let's right. Go hang around
and
someplace.
Well,
in
you
the mouth. Or
go ahead. Alberta! Alberta!
Oh, Billy, Billy, Billy! Is that you out there doing nothing?
Yeah! Come on out!
Here I go!
Yes! Here you come! Yes, he's coming! Here you go! There you are!
Okay.
Oh, okay. Hi.
Hi, here I am.
Yes, you sure are here. Oh, boy.
I've been waiting for you, Billy.
Oh, yeah?
I even put on a couple of my new dresses.
Couple of new dresses?
Uh-huh.
Oh, it's very nice. Well, especially the one in the middle.
Yeah. Hey, can I sit down there with you?
Well, I don't mind as long as the steps don't. Come
okay.
on.
No, don't.
Sorry.
You want some? No.
Well,
here. Mm. No, that's all right. You might get fat.
Oh, okay.
Well, that's some good old stuff that I can.
Yes, it is. Here, I'll give you some more room.
Okay.
There you are.
Hey, for a kid of 13, you sure got a big beard.
Yeah, well, I was trying to pass for 15, you know.
Oh.
Well, I see you're still on your diet.
Yeah. Shoot. Of course I am.
Yeah. I don't know how you do it. I mean, if my daddy owned a big old candy store with a fountain and everything, I'd be as big as the house. How do you keep your figure?
Well, first of all, you see, I don't eat no bread, and I don't eat no butter.
I see.
And you know how long it's been since I had a potato?
Well, I imagine it's been like a month of Sundays.
See, I gotta keep my weight down, Bill, because I want you to be proud of me.
Oh, shucks. I am proud of you. You're my big rock candy mountain.
Well, why don't you take your big rock candy mountain to the dance Friday night?
To the dance Friday, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Alberta, Friday I have basketball practice. I have to practice basketball with the boys. They just left, and they said, don't forget to come by basketball practice. Very important.
But this is the biggest dance of the year.
Well, I'm sorry about that, but Friday night is when I play basketball. Sorry.
Gee, that's too bad.
Mm-hmm.
Because Daddy's bringing along 10 chocolate cream pies and 5 gallons of ice cream. It's too bad.
10 chocolate cream pies and 5 gallons of ice cream?
Yeah, and probably some cookies, too. And maybe some candy, too.
What if, you're talking about this Friday?
Uh-huh.
This Friday? It's this Friday? Oh, well, shucks, that's no problem if it's this Friday. I thought you meant next Friday. This Friday, I can make it. 5 gallons of ice cream?
Oh.
You know this Friday is the Friday we don't have basketball, right?
Oh, you don't?
Oh, of course not.
Yeah. I'm so happy.
Yes.
Wanna know why?
Why?
Because after Friday, I won't be seeing you for a long time.
How come?
Well, see, Daddy just told me that he's moving the candy store all the way over to the other side of town.
Huh?
Yeah.
You're moving the candy store?
Yeah.
You're positive?
I'm very positive. You see, the van is coming to pick up the furniture Saturday morning, and it's coming back to pick me up Saturday night.
Well, you wouldn't be leaving any candy behind when you go, would you?
We don't leave no candy behind. We don't even leave wrappers.
I see. And the fountain's going, too, I guess.
Yeah, down to the last ice cream scoop.
Ah. Taking everything and just gonna leave me here to starve, huh?
Oh, Billy, you're probably gonna forget me anyway.
Oh, there's no chance, Alberta. You're the biggest thing in my life.
Would you ever come to see me, Bill?
See you? We're going to get married, ain't we?
I hope so.
Well, I'll see you then.
Wow. I guess that means that... Want to put your arm around me?
Yeah, okay.
This one?
Uh-huh.
I guess that means that we're kind of going steady.
Uh-huh.
I really think you're terrific, Bill.
Yeah.
Hey, would you tell me all the things you like about me?
Mm.
I mean...
Well, I mean, there's so much. I don't know.
Come on, Bill, just start any place. Just tell me, I gotta hear it.
Well, I don't really know where to start. I mean, because, I like your brother, you know. I like your mother. And, I like you.
We'll get a preacher.
A preacher already? I'll buy the ring.
And we can hire a band.
Yes, with a violin and an accordion.
And a tenor who can sing. You and me. You and me, baby, you and me. You and me. You and me, baby, you and me. You and me. You and me, baby, you and me. You and me. You and me. We'll have a kid.
We may have to rent one.
he's got to be straight.
Cause we don't want a bent one.
We sure don't want no bent one.
No.
He'll drink his baby blue
from a big breast cup.
Someday he may be president. If things loosen up.
Yes. Okay then.
You and me. You and me, baby. You and me. You and me.
Hurt yourself.
You and me, baby. You and me. You and me. You and me, baby. You and me. You and me. You and me.
When our kids are grown.
With kids of their own. They'll send us away.
Oh.
A little home.
In Florida, we will play checkers.
When checkers can be fun.
Yeah.
Let's do it again. You and me. You and me, baby. You and me. You and me. You and me, baby. You and me. You and me. You and me, baby. I can touch my toes.
I don't believe it.
I do.
You made it.
You and me. You and me. You know what, Bill? I think I want to have a big house with a white picket fence.
Oh, no, black picket fence.
I want to have 12. And now it's time to make room for everybody's granddaddy, Danny Thomas.
Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you, Diana. I'm so pleased that you could take time from your busy schedule to be a guest on my show.
Wait,
and now,
wait.
What, dear?
Whose show?
My show.
Guess again.
Well, oh, this is your show.
Yeah.
I forgot. You know, for a minute there, I thought it was my show and then you were my guest. But actually, it's really very, very nice to be somebody else's guest. I mean, I can relax. The paces couldn't be more relaxed, and the hours couldn't be shorter, and the dressing room couldn't be smaller.
Are you unhappy with your dressing room?
Oh, no, no. It's all right. It's a little small, but I love it because it's so close to the stage.
Good.
But a 10-minute cab ride, if I make all the lights.
Danny, you're such a great entertainer. In fact, I bet I wouldn't get an argument from anyone if I say you were America's number one storyteller.
Well, you wouldn't get an argument from me. That's a cinch. Bob Hope, maybe, but not me.
I wish you could make people laugh the way you do.
Oh, honey, the way you sing, you shouldn't wish for anything. You sing so beautifully, you know? And here you are wishing. If I could sing like you, I'd have my nose fixed in the morning, I swear.
You know, I think there's a lot of people that can sing, and I'd love to be able to just tell a funny story, you know, to make people laugh.
Well, honey, anybody can tell a funny story. I could teach you in 3 minutes.
Nah, you couldn't teach me.
I'll bet you $5 I can teach you to tell a funny story.
$5?
Yeah, and if I lose, I'll throw in my dressing room, too.
You'll lose, Danny.
No, I won't. Look, there's certain standard classic jokes, honey, and they just don't miss. For example, I'll give you one, a real easy one. It's a classic, very old. Try this one.
Oh, listen.
Now, there's an old lady now, lives by herself, except she's got a poly parrot. Uh-huh. Talking bird. Parrot, right? But all this parrot can say is, who is it? Who is it? That's all a parrot can say. Who is it? So one day, while the old lady's out shopping, the plumber comes to the door. He knocks on the door, and the parrot says, who is it? And the plumber says, it's the plumber. The parrot says, who is it? He says, it's the plumber. The plumber. The parrot says, who is it? The man says, it's the plumber! The parrot says, who is it? The plumber! The plumber! Well, he screamed so loud, he had a heart attack and he fell over dead in the doorway. There he is, dead in this woman's doorway. Now she comes home from shopping, and she sees this man lying there dead, and she says, "Who is it?" And the parrot says, "It's the plumber." Classic story. You can't miss with that one. Practice.
No,
and next time you do a concert or a cafe, you'll be telling jokes. Now, go on. Tell.
No.
You would bet $5. You don't want to lose, do you?
All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll help you. Go on.
A lady owns a parrot.
Yeah.
And the only thing the parrot can say is, "Who is that? Who is that?"
Honey, it's not a Jewish
that?
Bird, kid.
Who is that? Who is that? Who is that?
Yeah. Okay.
It's a pretty funny joke.
Well, you haven't finished it yet.
Oh.
You only got as far as, "Who is it?" All right, go ahead.
"Who is that?"
No. Can you get off of "Who is that?" and do the story?
All right, okay.
Right.
One day, a lady goes out shopping.
Right.
And while she's gone, the parrot goes to the door, and the plumber says, "Who is that?" And the parrot says, "Drop dead."
You didn't tell the story right.
Then how come I got a bigger laugh than you did?
Because you got mostly Motown people out here. That's why you didn't get a laugh. Money isn't everything. Here's your $5.
Thank you very much, sir.
I think I'll go back to my dressing room. Taxi! Taxi!
Works every time. Last week I got Bob Hope for 10.
Remember me as the sound of laughter and my face, the moment after did the sky that can't stay. You remember my heart to fall, but don't forget me in your tender.
know there's an old saying that a picture's worth a thousand words? Well, a funny picture's worth a thousand laughs. And the old-time movies prove that. I get a chance to watch some of them sometimes. And I have some favorite stars. Some of them are Chaplin, W.C. Fields, the Marx Brothers. They could make you laugh without even saying a word.
Thank you.
once again, ladies and gentlemen, the world's most fabulous group, the Jackson Five. You can depend and never worry.
No wind, no rain, all winter's cold. Oh, babe, you must follow the sun wherever it leads. But remember, if you should fall short of your desires, remember life holds for you one guarantee. You'll always have me. And if you should miss my lover one of these old days, if you should ever miss the arms that used to hold you so close, or the lips that used to touch yours so tenderly, just remember what I told you the day I set you free.
Ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough, keep me from you. Ain't no mountain high enough, ain't no valley low enough, ain't no river wide enough, keep me from you.
Each and every one of you. Thank you and good night.